Hello, my gorgeous, gorgeous gays, days, ghouls, guys, thems. Said that completely wrong. Let's try this again. Hello, my gorgeous, gorgeous friends. Hello to the ghouls, the guys, the gays, days, and thems. There we go, we got it that time. It's been a while since I made a video, a regular video. Anywho, before we get started, make sure you are subscribed to the support group gang, okay? If you need a friend, be a friend. You can find it all here. We got cookies, coffee, tea, brownies, everything in the back. You know, the circle is never full. If you need some support, we are here for you. Make sure you hit the notification bell so you know every time I upload on Sundays, my vlogs, and Mondays are bonus videos like this one. Ooh, already with the bloopers, you can tell it's been a while. So, make sure you also share. Share if you wanna be shady, share if you wanna be supportive, share, just share. Share to your play cousins, Ray Ray and them, Bay Bay and them, all of them, your aunties, your uncles, your sisters, your half-sisters, your play sisters, your play cousins, all of the above. Without further ado, let's get started. Hi, if you're new here, my name is Shalar and welcome to my channel. It is a safe space for all. If you don't know what we do over here, we are all about alternative lifestyle, beauty, luxury, on a budget, and health. Okay, baby? Okay. I hope you stay, whatever attracted you to be here. I hope you keep staying and you bring others with you. First eyeshadow palette we're gonna talk about is the one I'm actually wearing on my eyes. It is the OPB Beauty Bloom Palette, okay? Cute, cute. She is doing all of the autumnal things. Can you see that? Look at them colors, baby, look at them colors. I'm currently wearing this shade, and this shade. And this one, and this one. That's what's on my eyes today. Just this palette. I actually really like this palette. This is the first time I'm using this palette. I've had this palette for like a year now and I bought it on sale. I'm pretty sure you can still get it from them. I will link all of the products down below. Just so it's easy to find it. If it's not linked, that means you can't get it anymore and it was probably limited edition or they just discontinued it due to like productivity issues and like supply issues. Moving on. Next is from Beauty Bay. This was actually in like a pack. So I think you can buy it by itself, but it's in a pack that I got it in. So it's the Earthy palette, giving you very much deep greens, giving you fall foliage or like transitional foliage from summer to fall, but really good greens if you're a green person. Next, I'm not really sure if you can still get this palette, but I'm pretty sure you still can get this palette. It's the 420 palette from Melt Cosmetics. I actually really like this palette. I like the neon green on the end. This one, but look at it, it's giving grungy fall and I love it. Look at it. This next palette, I haven't actually used this next palette, but I like swatched every single thing in it and I did a series on in my shorts last year when it came out and on TikTok and Instagram. It's the Lunar Beauty 12 Days of Lunar. It was from their advent calendar, so you can't actually get this again. I don't think so. I'm gonna double check, but I'm pretty sure you can't. Love this color story though, haven't gotten a chance to really use it. Going to use it though this year, definitely gonna use it. Next is a personal fave because it's about where I live, and if you're not from New York then you don't know this place, but Nomad Cosmetics, if you know Nomad Cosmetics, they do palettes based off of places around the world. One of the owners grew up like 20 minutes to like half an hour from where I live, and it's the Hudson Valley palette. I live in the Hudson Valley. I've lived in the Hudson Valley my entire life. So this was hitting home and I was like, oh yeah, most definitely have to have it because it's my home. And then, baby, look at the autumnal vibes. Look at that. First of all, this deep red, fire. And these cool tones, even more fire. Stunning. Next palette is the Lunar Beauty Eternal Eclipse palette. First of all, the packaging for Lunar Beauty is just, I love it. But let's take a look at it because it's giving cool tone realness. Cool tone realness. Cool tone realness. Yes. Next is a sad one, but it's a good one. It's the Sydney Grace Tiny Marvels palette with Mel Thompson. Rest in peace, Mel Thompson. But she put together a bomb palette because Sydney Grace's formula slept on. Slept on. Because this gold? Oh, I, on my TikTok, early in my TikTok, like maybe 2020 or 2021, I did like 4 looks with this palette alone. I love this palette. I know it looks like it hasn't been used, but it's been used. It's just that pigmented that you don't have to dig into the shadows to use them. This one's a favorite. This one is a favorite. I've used this one faithfully every year. And it's the Natasha Denona Glam Palette. By the way, for those of you who are new, I have a speech impediment, so I have a lisp. Some things are hard for me to say, and I stutter a lot when it comes to things. I trip over my tongue a lot, okay? Point blank period. But here we go. Here's the Glam Palette. I know, it looks a little ashy. It's not. It's not. Natasha Denona be playing with y'all. It's not. It's not ashy at all. It's fine. It's phenomenal. And it's a great sister palette for any other Natasha Denona palette you have. This one's from Unearthly Cosmetics. It's the Leather and Lace palette. I actually really like this palette. I should use it more often. I think my favorite row is the green row. And this shimmer called Chantilly, like Chantilly Lace. Chantilly. I actually really like saying the word Chantilly. Don't know why. But I like the gradients. It's easy. In case you don't know how to do your eye, there it is for you. No questions asked. Or if you want to switch it up, you can go this way. You can go this way. Like, they all work together. This is a great, easy palette. Speaking of gradients and easy palettes, I could not do this video without a Blend Bunny palette. Let's be honest. The hype is real. The hype is real. Okay, so this is the All Done Up palette. It's actually the smaller end of the size palettes that she's put out. But more gradients. In case you didn't know how to do your eye, it literally goes in order for you. And yes, even the light shades, the pastels, work for us. In case you were wondering, it works on the black and brown girlies too. So whether you're new in the makeup game or old, this next palette is an oldie but a goodie, and you can still get it. I'm pretty sure you can still get it. And it is the Norvina Volume 3 palette. Look how pretty it is. It screams fall. If fall could smack you in the face, it would be this palette. Look at it. It would just smack you. Listen. It's got your oranges, your greens, yellows, little plum colors in here. The shimmers in this palette are really good. Now, this, it does require a learning curve. So if you're new to this, you know, kind of lifestyle of makeup, I don't know if I would necessarily recommend getting this right away, because it takes a lot of blending and it builds nicely. But if you don't know how to do it, like, it'll get stuck in the spot. You gotta blend. It's a whole thing. It's a learning curve. It is definitely a pressed pigments palette, meaning they're prone to staining your eyes. Honestly, if you use an eyeshadow primer, not concealer, an eyeshadow primer, there's a difference, because concealer will still stain your eye. Eyeshadow primer will lower the chances of eyeshadow staining your eye by a lot. And it holds better on creasy eyes like myself, okay? First foundation, if you haven't tried it yet, it is Lady Gaga's House Labs foundation. Great for fall, semi-matte, soft matte, whatever you want to call it. Lightweight, it's giving skin. Once you put on everything else, it's giving skin. Next is the Morphe foundation. I know, Morphe. I know, who would have thought? This one is really good. This is the one where Makeup Shayla and Danessa Myricks were the face of the campaign. For a reason. The shade range on this is really good. And as controversial as Morphe can be, they put their foot in this one. This one's good. Hydrating without being super dewy. And I want to say like a satin finish. So if you put powder on it, it holds powder really well. And if you don't put powder on it, you don't look like a grease ball. I'm loving this one. Next, Makeup by Mario. Giving hydration queen. Giving glow from within. Giving photo shoot ready. Even when you put powder on and it settles nicely. Oh, this is a good one. I've used this one a fair amount too. Oh, the hype is real. Hype is real on this one. I don't see the little glitter particles that people be talking about. Oh wait, do I? Oh wait, that's the first time I've ever seen them. Oh, they're in there. They're just very fine. Especially if you have a darker skin tone, you're really not gonna see it. This would not be a good video without, you know, Mama Fenty out here. Riri, definitely put her foot in this. I know some people say this is too matte for them, but I feel like for fall and winter, if you are doing stuff, like walking around, applying and stuff like that, you'd want this one, because as time goes on, it starts to look more natural. When your natural oils seep through, and it doesn't look like you're a grease ball, it doesn't look like a greasy mess. It just looks like, oh, you put on foundation today. You look good. You know, you look good. NARS Soft Matte. I still swear by this, okay? I actually just gave this to somebody. I gave the other shade I had to somebody. Baby, even she said that this was, she was like, oh, I really like this one. And she only used the Luminous NARS one, not the matte one. This is the first time she used the matte one. And she was like, oh, no, baby, I like this. I'm telling you, get you one of these. Get you one of these. I've been really feeling this one lately, and it's the Sephora Best Skin Ever Foundation, along with the concealers. When I tell you this is a really good one, and they say best skin ever, yo, this foundation is great for underpainting. So if you do your bold highlight contour and then put this on top, baby, baby, baby. Lastly, this one is actually being discontinued. I just got another one in an order, but it's the NYX Born to Glow. I don't know why they're discontinuing this, but they put their foot in this. I never got the concealers because I just felt like that was too much radiance, but the foundation, this one's almost done. It's a good thing I got another one, but this one's almost done, and I don't understand why, because you could get this one in Walmart, you could get it in Walgreens, you can get it at your drugstore, like, I don't know, and it was only $10. I don't know why they're discontinuing this, but if you can find your shade somewhere, get it before they're gone. Get it. First powder foundation, naturally the Fenty one. Great for setting. This one's actually almost done for me, and I'll probably need a new one. See, I hit pan. Yeah, yeah. I'm gonna need a new one soon. I don't know if I bought a new one already, but I'm gonna need a new one. This is really good to set your concealers and stuff like that, especially on the days where you don't want to put on actual foundation. So like, that's what I did today. Not with this one, but I did put on powder foundation to set my forehead and around my mouth. And as you can see, it's still giving full coverage, full beat, full everything. Next is the One Size Beauty one. The hype is real on this one. This is a really good powder foundation. I don't know about putting it on top of the BBB cream, because that's a lot. And then adding the waterproof setting spray, that's a lot. So unless you live in like Arizona or Texas or Nevada where it's hot, I don't see why you need all three of those layered in a regular, like, I don't get it. That is too much Snatchington for me, okay? But individually, fire products. All together? Yeah, no. Juvia's Place Powder Foundation. When I tell you this one was actually a pleasant surprise, I made a little dent in it, baby. Pleasant surprise. It sets nicely. That's pretty much all I can say. This one, I just like it. And I only have 4 powder foundations that I use, so that's why I brought it up, because I don't buy powder foundation like that, so I have to like actually like the product to want to have it. So yeah, I like it. It's good. I use it for like work. It's good for like natural everyday makeup. It's a good one. And the one that I'm wearing today is actually the She Glam one. Yes, I know you're like, what? Wow. Yeah, yeah, that's the one I'm wearing today. It looks very light, but it does like deepen when you spray your face. Next up are concealers. I buy concealers in threes because I contour, highlight, and then like brighten with concealer. So that's why each set will have 3. So let's get into that. Not enough strong. She Glam. Yes, She Glam. This is what I mean by like, I buy them in threes. Dark for contouring, skin tone, brightening. These look very light. This is pretty light for contouring, but this is like if I'm gonna do like a daytime look. If I decided to contour for work, I would use this one. But creamy. Great if you're great balance between this and the Fenty one. Yes, creamy and not too hydrating that it would crease like crazy, but hydrating enough that your face isn't like dying from dehydration. These are a little pricey, but these are the Amy Cole concealers from Sephora. I actually really like these. These are also really creamy. These are like the higher end version of the She Glam ones. So the She Glam ones would be a dupe of these. One Size, great for underpainting. Great for longevity. Great for you planning to go hiking and you still want to put on a full face. I don't know why you would do that, but if you decided to do that, this is what I would recommend. Fenty, same thing as those. They're not even dupes for each other. They just happen to do the same thing. This one's actually a little bit more hydrating than that one, I would think. In my opinion, they are. But doesn't clock out until you tell her it's time to go home, okay? She is there, she is staying, she is the moment. And then last, the best skin ever concealers. Like, Bro, the same exact thing I said about the foundation, the concealers are fire. The concealers are fire. They're giving skin, okay? They're giving hydration. They're giving we drink our water and mind our business.
Yes. Blushes! I really like blushes.
First blush, they're affordable. Maybelline Fit Me blushes. This is in the shade Wine Borgo. Yeah, Wine Borgo. I like these blushes a lot. I have like two or three of them. I like them. Same thing with the NYX Sweet Cheek blushes. These two are literally like the same shade, but affordable, cute, does the job. They're pigmented. They clock in, they hold up. They do what they're supposed to do. Melt Cosmetics blush lights. What are these called? I actually don't know what these called. Digital Dust Duos, that's what they're called. It is a blush light. It's literally blush highlighter. Great for subtle glow within, glow from within kind of look for daytime. Get you one of these. These are really good. Sephora's matte blush in Tiger Lily. I think it went viral at one point in time after I had already gotten it for a reason. Makes sense. Makes very much so sense. Yes, because yes. Just because yes. One size, naturally, the blushes, and they come with a cream, a powder, and a shimmer. Yeah, like a blush light. Yes, yes, so I have on the powder from this one and the powder from another one, and I'll show you the liquid blush shiz that I actually have on. Juvia's Place, the Saharan Blush Volume 1. The Volume 1, baby, because look at these colors. I mixed this orange powder with the one size powder. Yes, cause yes. Because as you can see, she's got some love to her. Because all of them are chef's kiss. Next, y'all know I got a code with them. So I'll put the code down there. Get a little coin off. I make a little coin. I'm going to tell you it's affiliated just so you know. But it's from Glam Ghoul Boutique. And it is the Glam Reaper palette. This is a new palette, new collection for me. But I'm really feeling it. Because look at the colors. Both palettes were giving the same vibes. This orange though is a, these two oranges have more of a reddish tone. So if you're warmer, these would work best for you, but they do like pull a different kind of color on me that are not like straight up true orange, but I love them and I could wear every shade in this palette. And I've worn this highlighter, yes. Not because I work with the brand, but this is actually a really good palette, I'm not gonna lie. I would tell you at this point in time if I wasn't a fan. Cause I don't even got enough subscribers and followers to be lying anyway. What's that gonna get me? I don't get paid from this, so why I need to lie? Liquid blushes. She Glam. This one's discontinued because it was limited edition, but it's the shade Pumpkin, and it was the collab between She Glam and the YouTuber Darcy. Yeah, the Black Girl Tries girl. She created this liquid orange blush. I actually did buy a second one because I needed to make sure. I mixed that last blush with this blush, the Made by Mitchell blush in Riptide. I actually really like this blush. It's more of a cool tone blush, cool tone orange. And you're probably like, that's really light. Nah, it look good. Let me tell you, it look good. Especially when you layer them and do a little ombre something with the other one. Yes, yes, yes. Last but certainly not least, the Rare Beauty blushes. The hype is real. Get you some. I got dewy and matte. This is the shade Love, the matte version of the dewy one in the similar shade, which is Joy. And I want to try their purple one because I've been into purple blush lately. I'm gonna do bronzers real quick because I only got two bronzers. So first bronzer, one size. Yes, great for winter, fall, because you're tanning down. So these are like lighter shades. Standard, I like them. They hold up, they do really well, okay? Next is from Glam Goth Beauty. Look at that, all the glams, all the ghouls, all the goths, all the girls, okay? But it's an eye and face palette. So it blush, contour, bronzer, eyeshadow. You can use it for everything, but you can tell that down here I use a lot because I use it for my bronzer and I've used these for blushes before. All four of these make a good gradient blush, just so you know. And these, you can use these as like inner corner highlights, little cut crease, you know, the whole nine, the whole shebang. Love it, love it, love it, love it, love it. Next will be eyeliners, because I only have like three that I would really recommend for right now. The first two are actually the same, just different shades. And it's also the She Glam liquid liner pens. Never thought, these were literally like $5. So I have black and brown. Brown is great for fall. And if you just wanna thicken up your lash line before you put on mascara and do the whole no makeup makeup, brown is your girl. But pigmented, they hold on to, if the black one's what I have on right now. They hold on, they do their job, they clock in, they don't clock out. Next, I've talked about this eyeliner for like a couple years now from when they came out with it, and it's the Epic Wear Liner from NYX. This is the black one. I have it in multiple colors, and they're metallics because, yes. So the She Glam one is on my inner corner, and this is my wing. Pigmented, black, and it stays. Next is lip liners. I'm gonna try and run through the lip liners because all the lip liners have the same qualities. They stay, they're dark enough for the brown girlies and the black girlies, and they're smooth, so they glide on really nicely. First, Dose of Colors Chocolate Chip. This was a limited edition one. It was a collab with Nima Tang, so you probably can't get this one, but it's super dark. Super dark, don't know if you can even see that. Super dark. If you can still get it, I'll link it. If not, then I'm sorry. Brown gel liner from One Size Beauty. Actually an eyeliner, I use it as a lip liner. Anytime you see me with a nude lip, this is the brown liner. Yes. The black version of that liner, also a yes, for the same exact reasons. And I've used it together, and they blend really nicely together. Blend Bunny Cosmetics lip liner. These actually surprised me. I tried only two of them. This is the darker one, and it's a vampy one. Yes, I really like this one. Juvia's Place Cola. Every black girl's talked about it. There's a reason why they've talked about it. If you don't know, go find out. And then this one was a pleasant surprise. I got this one in an emergency because I was going somewhere and didn't have a liner, but the NYX retractable lip liner, these are really good. Like, pleasantly surprised, these are really good. The rumors were true, the hype is real. The One Size setting sprays. I had these before Beyonce ended up getting it on her, and then everyone's selling it out, so good for me for acting fast and having good intuition. I'm also an actual makeup artist, for those of you who don't know. So yeah, I was already going to try it and stuff like that. So I do have a second one too. So when they restock eventually, I'll get some more. But this was really good. I really like this. Makeup Revolution Super Hold Misting Spray. This is a really good spray. I'm not saying it's a dupe for anything, but it's a good spray. Auntie Charlotte. Yes. Cause yes. I was skeptical about this one at first. Didn't like it at first, but it's grown on me. Like it. Really like it. Especially when I'm doing my regular everyday makeup for work. Yes. This last one, this is my new one. So I haven't opened it really yet, but I'm opening it until y'all can see it. This is the All Nighter Vitamin C Spray. This one and the purple one, the original All Nighter. Those are my go-to from Urban Decay. I keep rebuying those, and I actually do need to re-up because I think this is my last one from Urban Decay. So I have to buy a new one soon once that's done. But I'm trying to finish up a lot of setting sprays anyway, so that's gonna probably be for a little while. Moving on to lips. Okay, so for lips, we're gonna start off with a lip balm. It's the Summer Friday Vanilla Lip Balm. This is their Butter Balm, Lip Butter Balm. I got this for free to test out, and I'm in love, so I kinda wanna buy one, and I heard they have a chocolatey nude one, and I'm into brown glosses lately, so I kinda wanna get that one. And another one of these. Cause look how skinny it, cause I've been using it. It's a good lip balm. Other than that, I just use like Burt's Bees and ChapStick. Next is the color I actually have on. It is the Kaleidos Cloud Lip Paints. I love the formula on these for fall and winter regardless of the color, because they are matte, but they're comfortable, they're lightweight, and they're hydrating all at the same time, because it's a lip clay. I will say, because of all of that, it is not transfer proof. There's a little transfer there, but it's transfer resistant, so there you go. See, they're still good, as you can see. Yeah, as you can say, get you some if you can. The next four are all from Black Moon Cosmetics, and it's because they're amazing. I don't remember the name of this color particularly, but, and the name came off the bottom, but this came in a trio with hazel, which is a green, it's like an olive green, which is really cute, and cider, which is a mustard yellow, which is really cute. Both, all three of them look fire with a brown lip liner. I've worn them in videos and you didn't even realize that's what I had on, and you would not think that that's the color I had on. And then my favorite black ever, why is it like this? Oh my god, did something spill on my thing? Oh, I think something spilled on it. But my favorite black ever is Sleepwalker. From them, when I tell you black is black, black is black. The next four are all the Maybelline Superstay matte inks, but these colors. These colors are all really good. Blue, because I just like blue lips. This taupe, I think taupe looks great on black girls. Y'all need to start branching out. Start branching out. This great lip liner, or just full lip. This is a nice caramelly kind of brown, but like a deep caramel, so your lips won't look ashy. And then this other taupe color, which is like a lighter taupey purple. They're not the same shade. These next five are all from Colored Rain, and I think one of these was discontinued. I'm not exactly sure. I think it's the blue shade. But these four, so I think this is Heart of Stone, Empire, Blue Dragon, Speechless, and Ivy. But these are all really great colors, and I really like these. Next, we have another one size beauty product. You would think they were sponsoring this video in some way, shape, or form, but no, they have really good products. These dual end lipstick lip glosses. First of all, this brown lip gloss is what I wore on my anniversary. So if you saw my Instagram story and you saw all the glitter and you were like, ooh, girl, your lips look good, it was this gloss. And I have it in a nude shade with the gloss, fire, and then this deep brown, fire. Just fire. I have these two colors also from the Nima Tang and Dose of Colors collab, but I think I have the lipstick in my bag and I just didn't realize it was in my bag. But this dark brown lip gloss, and then it comes with a matching dark brown liquid lip. Fire. But then they also have another brown liquid lip called Chocolate Wasted that you guys should definitely check out because it's fire. It's a little lighter than this one, but it's still a deep brown and it looks good on the brown girlies, I'm just saying. Okay, our last lip and product of this entire video is the Lunar Beauty liquid lipstick in Hallows Eve. It's an orange, bright orange. Looks really good with a brown lip liner. Fire, definitely a good formula. Check out Lunar Beauty if you can. I know it seems like I don't use their stuff, even though I have their stuff. I use their stuff. I actually have one of their palettes sitting on my vanity because I use it regularly, and I told you I travel with it. So that is all the products. Thank you for sticking with me so far. I know this video was long. I'm gonna try and make sure I can condense it in editing as much as possible. And I tried to keep the excess talking down to a minimum as well. But I hope it was useful. I hope if you like any of the products, you do try them out for yourself, see if you like them. And until next time, remember to stay creative, stay strong, stay positive. Always think about how you want the world to perceive you and present that version of yourself to the people, and stay beautifully you.